Wait, wait, wait. This isn't Star Wars. Go ahead and look around. You aren't going to find any Jedi or Wookiees. No. What you are going to find are a lot of faces. Some faces may be old. Some may be new. Some faces might have spent most of their lives in this very community. We have hard workers, jokesters, friends, and lots of memories. Each one a little more unique than the last. As our time nears the end, we look back on all the moments we spent together. This was our journey. Okay, so by now, you probably figured out, this is a documentary about all the seniors from Colonel Crawford. And you know what? Crawford wouldn't be the same without them. Here at Crawford, we have some of the best seniors in the area. That could be because they're such hard workers. I mean, you can almost see the enthusiasm bursting out of them, right? Yeah, well, believe it or not, classes aren't all that bad.
So, he wasn't committing any of those things. But here again, none of those are protected.
Let's just say, we've come a long way from that 2 plus 2 equals 4 kind of math.
What's the other one? What's the equation? Is it 1/3 x minus 1/3?
Yeah, that is definitely not 2 plus 2. Well, maybe the singers are so great because of our amazing diets. Come on, who doesn't like Sloppy Joe? Anyway, back to the point. There are a lot of things in Colonel Crawford that make it so unique. And among those things is definitely the pride that we take in our sports. For instance, look at all of our all-state athletes. I mean, we need a whole hallway for them. And among all of these sports, football is definitely one of the most talked about. 2013 was a pretty memorable year for football. Florida State had a heck of a season to win the BCS Bowl. And of course, Peyton Manning and the Broncos gave us a pretty bad display in the Super Bowl. But how many people will remember this team? Us seniors will never forget. This place is where it all starts. Ever since we were in elementary school, we came to the games to support the Eagles, and we knew that one day, we wanted to take part in what happens here on Friday nights. It may not look like much to you, but to most of us, it was like a second home. It's where we spent a lot of our time, learned about values, but more importantly, it's where our family was. For almost 6 months a year, these seniors were together in football. From the first day of early morning summer lifting to the last senior practice, they stuck together through all the adversity that they encountered. Believe it or not, the adversity helped most of these football seniors, and they took some lessons along with them.
That's helped me become more independent and more of a leader.
It's definitely helped me work as, like, just with teamwork and just hard work. Just, it's, like, this type of responsibility and just how to work hard.
Of course, it wouldn't be a football game without the band. Let's go over to senior drummer Jacob Coker.
I play what is commonly known as the quads, or the tenor drums, or the sextuplets as I call them, because I have six drums to actually play.
Now, what was your favorite game to play in?
Well, really, it's hard to pick which one's your favorite, quote-unquote, because they all are really fun. They all have their good memories. Winford game was really fun because there's a lot of people.
What's your favorite memory overall?
Probably our last show. I got to wear a Darth Vader helmet during halftime. That was really fun. It was a really good time.
Of course, you have to give the band their credit. But I think we all know the real reason that people come to the games, and that's to support their Colonel Crawford Eagles. This year was a big season for those senior Eagles. You could probably say that it was a season for the history books. They fought their way through a tough schedule of opponents.
From this season, we've had a lot of big games. The Winford game was a big game for us. Upper was a big game. And believe it or not, Crestline was a big game to get a home seed.
It's been a very good year. I'm going 9-1. And we haven't done that since 27 years. So, pretty good season.
If you've played high school football, you know that there's no feeling better than getting out on that field on Friday night and playing in front of your entire community. Here's a little taste of the pregame rituals and the game itself. And what better game to watch than the first ever home playoff game in Colonel Crawford history? Here's just a normal look at a walk through the senior hallways of Colonel Crawford. We spent 4 years here, and the end is finally in sight. One thing we can't forget about on the home stretch is keeping up with our academics. And as you can see, we're taking that very seriously here. But really, all joking aside, academics are a big part of Colonel Crawford. Over the years, we've actually got some excellence ratings as a school. Our past seniors have gone on to college, sure, but they come back every year to give the new seniors some advice and tips on college. And we like to call that day Eagle Reunion Day.
So many organizations there. In the first week, we had just one day where all the organizations set up a booth outside. And I mean, there are so many things you can get into. There's like pistol club.
There's hundreds. There's dodgeball club. There's
tightrope.
Fencing. There's
movie club.
So many community. There's like Nation India club. I mean, everything you can imagine, they have it.
So, I mean, there's something.
Some of the graduates come back to talk their own colleges up a little.
Well, you all know who I am. For those of you who don't know, my name is Peyton. I go to Tiffin University.
Now, overall, these graduates gave us a lot of great advice.
We have entertainment every day. They will bring musicians. They will bring comedians.
And Tyler Smith just said, he's like, don't skip class. You're paying for it. Go to class.
Don't like spend all night long trying to finish in just one night. It's dumb. It's not fun.
Before we get to college, though, we can strive for one thing.
Students have been selected by exhibiting extraordinary leadership, character, citizenship, and service, all while maintaining a 3.5 or higher grade point average.
Becoming a member of the Colonel Crawford chapter of the National Honor Society is one of the greatest academic honors that Colonel Crawford students can receive. Of course, to become a member, you have to take part in the induction ceremony. Don't let me tell you about it, though. Just see for yourself.
Always building up their own characters and carrying out these motives. Membership in this society is considered one of the highest honors that this school can confer. A member of the society is a member of a national organization that is representative in over 6,000 secondary schools in the United States and foreign countries. We can feel justly proud to have the National Honor Society in Colonel Crawford High School.
Knowledge is one great element in life which leads to the highest success. It can only be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Learning furnishes the lamp by which you read the past and the light which illuminates the future.
The price of leadership is sacrifice, the willingness to yield one's personal interests for the interests of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate, no matter what power and resources may exist in the country.
I state your full name.
I
Captain Walter.
Pledge myself to uphold.
Pledge myself to uphold.
The high purposes.
The high purposes.
Of the National Honor Society.
Of the National Honor Society.
To which I have been selected.
To which I have been selected.
Striving in every way.
Striving in every way.
By word and deed.
By word and deed.
To make its ideals.
To make its ideals.
The ideals of my school and of my life.
The ideals of my school and of my life.
You may have blood or paint.
Finally, at the end of the ceremony, the inductive members light their candles and prepare to become members of the National Honor Society. Let's speed this up a little bit. One new thing that National Honor Society did this year was sell coffee to students on Wednesday mornings. Believe it or not, it actually kind of became a hit. I guess a lot of students here like coffee. One more thing that National Honor Society did was organize a student versus teacher volleyball game.
Mr. Ref, who do you think has the edge on this game?
Honestly, I think the students have a really good chance because the teachers are really old and, how do you say it, slow. And usually experience triumphs over skill, so it should be interesting.
So you're not a little biased towards the students, are you? You're going to call a fair game today, right?
I'm going to be extremely biased towards the students.
Here's the student team. Here's the teacher team. Maybe a little bit of glee humor in there. Ah, the hallways of Colonel Crawford. Come on, I'll take you on a little tour around the place. Not like I really need to, since you've been walking these hallways for about 4 years now. And I mean, not much has really changed. For instance, same old cafeteria. We have some doors. We have clocks. We have goldfish. Yeah, we actually do have those. And we have a library. Some more doors. An unfinished mural. And there's an exit sign. Okay, well, point is, not much has changed at Crawford for the past couple years. Sure, there's different students and different teachers. Same old school building, though. And unfortunately, it's also the same old Ohio. This year, that meant a lot of snow. And a lot of snow days. Some days the roads looked like this, and you all know, we still had to come in. So in the memory of this terrible winter, here's a little montage of what the roads looked like and what our school looked like during this Christmas season. Needless to say, this will probably be a winter that us seniors will never forget. Look at the bright side though, it did have its perks. We got a lot of days off of school. Another good thing was watching the basketball team play. I mean, looking in our gym, it might not look like much now, but when we get a packed house in here, man, does it get crazy. When I say basketball, I'm not just talking about boys' varsity basketball. The girls' basketball team might not have had their best season ever. They still had a lot of ups in the season. The boys' JV team also had a pretty good season. Anyway, the main story of this article is going to be about the boys' varsity basketball team. We had a lot of returning seniors this year. Seniors who wanted to come back and just have fun in basketball. Finish their senior year out as hard as they could. And with a crowd like this behind them, that was usually a pretty easy job. This was just one of the many games that the varsity team played this year. This one was against Riverdale. They were a real good team in the NCC, but I guess they didn't know we were too.
So that's good.
Now let's let the student section do their thing and get this game going. You really have to be here to experience Colonel Crawford and understand exactly what it is. It's like I said before, we have a lot of characters here. There's definitely a lot of diverse people. So if you want to just go and make the accusation that we're all farmers and drive tractors to school, you're wrong. Okay, you're wrong most of the time. Mostly, we have seniors trying to make it through high school alive. And this year, trying to do their senior projects any way that they can. For 4 years now, the teachers at this high school have had to put up with us seniors. We didn't exactly make it easy, but I think we all turned out all right. We have a lot of memories in this school, and as it turns out, we have a lot of opinions about it. I talked to some of the seniors and some of the teachers, because I wanted to know more. Here it is.
If you could sum up the class of 2014 in a word or two, what would it be?
In a word or two, 2014.
Interesting.
I see a lot of potential in that class, so that would be one word.
I can't do
that. Word or two?
Yeah.
The other word would be initiative, and I think that goes along with it. A lot of them have an initiative to do something great, so I think that's going to carry them to fulfilling that potential.
I would say that they are different in a good way, interesting and different.
Ornery.
I'm going to say hard workers.
They're a very social group. I think that they like to spend time with each other. I think that outside school activities are very important to them, and that you see that in the classroom a lot.
Crazy.
Okay.
And two words?
A word or two. Crazy's fine.
Graduating.
They're an awesome group of kids. I've known them since kindergarten.
Out of this world. Obnoxious. You have no idea what you're getting day to day.
What do you think about Colonel Crawford High School?
It's alright. Pretty cool.
I think it's old and run down. To be honest. I like it because it's small.
I think it's a great school compared to Buckeye, Winford, and all them. I mean, everybody knows everyone.
The school's kind of garbage compared to other schools. So, I mean, it ain't the best place.
I think Crow Crawford's a great school. Has a lot of great students, great teachers.
It's old, and it leaks all the time.
It's a good system, good teachers, good classes. High school could probably be renovated.
Okay, what are you going to miss about the school?
Everyone in it. Shayla.
Probably the other students and the teachers.
Being around, like being close to my friends.
Just being here with all my friends.
Probably the people, spending a lot of time here with all my friends.
Definitely my friends, and definitely the team activities I do after school.
I mean, I'm going to miss being here and seeing everyone, just seeing all my friends every day, but I'm not going to miss, like, the class. And
what class are you not going to miss?
Physics.
Why?
It's really, really difficult.
Geometry.
Why?
Because it's terrible and I never understood anything.
Government.
Art. Calculus.
Cheryl Corny's Spanish class. Probably the worst, one of the worst experiences of my life.
Physics.
Definitely chemistry.
Ms. Dugan.
I'm definitely not going to miss calculus.
What will you miss about class 2014?
The humor. Got a lot of good friendships, a lot of sense of humor.
All the trouble they give me.
I like picking on Craig Fruth, and he likes to pick on me, so I'll miss that.
It's a special class for me. First of all, it was a really good class. I enjoyed that.
Just the relationships I was able to develop with them and to get to know them.
I guess I would miss their joking around, their humor.
They weren't just classmates, but a lot of them have strong friendships.
I will miss their fun attitudes.
Everybody, but because my daughter's in the class, that's going to be, I'm going to miss her a lot.
It's been a fun experience, a lot of stories throughout the day, and a lot of fun throughout the day.
What was your favorite memory of your senior year?
Oh boy, there's tons, but probably, I guess, my favorite was the storming of the field when we beat Winford during football games, so.
Just playing football.
Getting to play this final year of basketball.
Spending a lot of time with the band.
When we beat Winford in football.
Charging the field during when we beat Winford.
My favorite memory is going to be, I mean, obviously it's going to be football.
Right with the guys in junior high football. We had a lot of fun.
Probably some of those seniors in when they were sophomores. I believe you were in that class?
Yes, I was in that class.
Being a room mother in their class parties. I enjoyed those.
I wouldn't say my fondest memory, but my
it was
most memorable, interesting class, yes.
There are too many.
there are just too many.
And having you guys be the guinea pigs for the senior project, and you freaking out with good attitudes and bad attitudes about it, you will always go down as the guinea pigs for the senior project.
All the misquotes in my classroom, Craig asking me every day why I hate them.
It's really memorable speeches, and when I think back to them, it just makes me laugh.
We had a lot of fun bringing life into the class.
What are you planning on doing after high school?
I'm going to go to Marietta College and play basketball.
After you graduate.
I'm going to Kent State University for...
Going to OSU Mansfield, majoring in early childhood education.
Sonography. That's what it was.
Me and my family are thinking about moving to Mexico.
So I'm going to try to get into an apprenticeship program to be an electrician and then just start from there.
Plan on going to OSU main campus and studying biochemistry.
Well, much like our senior year, this video is finally at its end. Graduation's on its way. We made it as seniors, and now it's time for us to step out into the real world. That doesn't mean that we need to forget about all the memories we've made here. From Whetstone and Sulphur Springs to a new school, and then the high school, we've just about seen it all. We've always had a home here at Crawford. We've had unforgettable times, made unmatchable friends, and we have stories that we'll probably be sharing for the rest of our lives. Seniors of 2014 always have the memories that we've made here over the years. As the years go on, we may lose touch with one another. We may move away and live our lives out to the fullest. But if we're lucky, we can think about it this way. We don't have to shut the book on our legacy here. We can just turn a new page.
This is Nick Adams for your breaking news. Okay.
What should I say? I don't know.
Do you have any words to leave the class of 2014 with?
I just wish them the best of luck and congratulate them. They're an awesome group of kids. I can't wait to see what they all end up doing.
I guess to be cliche, just work hard in life, find something that you love, and you'll find a happy life.
Keep doing what you're doing. Take that initiative and fulfill your potential. Enjoy life and have big dreams. Don't dream any small dreams, but go for your dreams.
Yes, when you get to college, make sure you take time to study and manage your time.
You've always known my angle. My angle is capitalism and democracy, and so I...
Don't socialize too much and ruin your future in college or whatever you may be doing. So make sure you take it seriously, whatever you do.
Good luck. Remember where you come from and dream big. Don't change.
Yeah, have a good life and stay on the table.